Like that. Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. Welcome to the Lebo gang. If you're new here, I really do hope that you're here to stay and that you press that subscribe button. But if you're my day ones, my regular degulars, welcome back, Lebo gang, to yet another video. Today I wanted to do a two-part series of like just one video because I wanted to shoot it on one day and do one intro. So firstly, I'm going to do my foundation routine and contour and highlighting, and then the second video I'm going to do this cut crease that I created. It was my first time doing this little glitter thing at the top. I don't have the right glitter, but I tried to make it work. But if you're interested to see how I achieved this eye look and how I got my foundation to sit so flawlessly and how I got this skin-like finish on my face, then do please carry on watching. Okay guys, so quickly I'm gonna run you through the products that I use to get a very flawless foundation application. Just a little disclaimer that it is kind of, not even kind of, it helps a lot to have smooth skin. And I'm not saying clear skin, because even if you do have some, what's this, dark spots or like pimples here and there, like as long as you have a smooth base, then the foundation application is so much easier. I'm going to run you guys through quickly because I don't have any space on this SD card. I need to get a new one, child. It's the ghetto. But I'm gonna show you guys the brushes that I use. This I use to put the foundation on my skin. So I'll put some foundation on the palm of my hand and I'll pick it up with this. And then I'll blend it out with this. This is a foundation flat brush. It's very dense. I got my brushes from Glow, take a lot. The black ones I got from Glow. The pink ones I got as a gift. If I'm not mistaken, she got them from take a lot. It was like a set of 24. And then to blend out my concealer, I use my beauty blender for the highlight. This is for highlighter, by the way. I do use my beauty blender, but I also use this to really get into the crease of my, you know, under eye. And then I use the same, what's this, foundation brush to get my contour in with the foundation that I did mention earlier. This I use to pat in the powder to set the highlighter. I find it so much better. Sorry, it is dirty.
Fuck.
And then I use this also, so it's the regular beauty blender. And then, because I start, before I do my eyeshadow, I do my face first, and my eyebrows, everything, and then I do my eyeshadow. I literally just spray, set everything with the setting spray. This is the W7 illuminating setting spray. It's almost done, I'm almost out. So if you want to be my sponsor, hit me up. DMs are open. And then I also set it again when I'm done. So I set my face twice because I'm trying to make sure that, you know, I'm intact. Nothing moves. You understand? I have very little time left, so I'm just gonna get right into our video. Guys, don't settle. This is so long. These niggas don't deserve us. Okay, I'm gonna get a copyright claim. So let's rather not. So let me start with my eyebrows. Okay, guys. So I just did my eyebrows off camera, and today was not a good day for my eyebrows, but it's gonna come together. I'm gonna make it come together. And then before I carry on with the rest of my face and before I forget, I'm going to put on some primer. So I have a mattifying primer from Essence. It's their Prime Plus Studio Mattifying Plus Pore Minimizing. It's a bit dirty, I'm so sorry, but that's how it looks. And it's got black clay. I don't know the significance of that and why it's helpful or useful. And then I have this Revlon one. It's a hydrating primer and it's also dirty. This one has lash glue, but anyways, it's this Rose Glow from Revlon, and this is a hydrating plus illuminating primer. So a mattifying primer would be used for the girlies with oily skin, right? So I've got combination skin, so during the winter my skin is extremely dry and I wouldn't use a mattifying primer. I'd definitely use a hydrating primer for that time of the year. And then during the summers, like you can see right now, my face is extremely oily and it's not even like I applied any like lotion or anything like that. If you have combination skin, I'd recommend this for winter time, and I'd definitely recommend this for the summer. But if you have oily skin, then definitely get a mattifying primer. And then if you've got dry skin, I'd recommend that you get a hydrating primer sharp. So gonna put that. I'm putting a lot, I know, but highest points of your face, by the way. Rub that into my skin. And my nose. I wanna try the Maybelline Baby Skin. Actually, I've never tried it. It's weird because that's like entry level beginner concealer primer. I don't know why I haven't tried it. But I need to try it. Just going to quickly do my eyebrows, the top. Oh, by the way, guys, I'm just blending that out with the beauty blender, but that's self-explanatory. Just gonna bring that up. Pinch your beauty blender like this so that you can get in between there. You understand? And just like that, my eyebrows look much better. Sorry, I thought a whole ass bitch was saying something.
But I thought a hating ass hoe said something. She didn't, because when I click clack, it's silent, ain't no fucking back talk. Yeah.
Guys, so like, the key to like getting like that perfect foundation base is just making sure that in between everything that you're doing, you keep blending that, if that's making sense. So now, before I've even moved on to my foundation, I'm making sure that what I've just put on my face, the concealer plus the foundation, is blended into each other and into my face. Can you see? I wouldn't put on foundation with that still there. I must make sure I've blended it into my skin. Do you understand? Nicely, so there aren't any weird lines. Just that one over there is something that I like personally, and that's why I go in with the light concealer for my eyebrows, is because I like that little halo effect that it does there without you even having to put on the like the highlighter at the end of the step. Not, you know which highlighter I'm talking about, like the powder highlighter. So I just like that effect for me. And that's just for me. If you don't like it, you can just go on with like a normal two shades, because this is probably like four shades lighter than me. Okay, so now that I'm quite satisfied with that blend, I'm going to conceal my underbag. So it's not showing nicely on the camera or through the camera, but I do have some darkness underneath my eyes and I just like to correct that. Okay, if you have dark spots on your face, I'd recommend, I don't have it right now with me, but I'd recommend that you get an orange color corrector. So orange color correctors help with concealing dark spots. So I would use that if I had it, if my eye bags were like the darkness under my, or the hyperpigmentation under my eyes. If it was that bad, then I'd definitely use it for my under eyes. But personally, I use a concealer. I use in the color Fawn. This is basically more or less the shade of my skin tone. So I put some underneath here before I put on my foundation, so that I can almost, my canvas is like even toned, if that makes sense. So that's what you'd do before your foundation applications. You'd use an orange color corrector, correct any dark spots that you may have on your face and just underneath your eyes, blend that in with the beauty blender or a foundation brush, and then you would put on your foundation. So I'm going in with Fawn, which is a concealer that's more or less my shade, if not one shade lighter. So I'm gonna put that right there. I'm gonna use my beauty blender to blend that out. Make sure to look up so that you get in the crease. Then just blend it with your eyelids. Once again, making sure that all the products on the face are blended into each other. So now we're taking that up. And then around the nose. And already, guys, like you can see, like, things look good. You understand? Chippy ki chippy. Stainless steel in kas chipolle. You understand? Okay. So now that that's done, we're gonna go on to foundation. I use the Clinique foundation. This is the Even Better Makeup with SPF of 15, and mine is in the color Golden. So since I concealed, corrected any mistakes with this foundation already at the top, and I moved that foundation up, there's absolutely no need for me to be going on with foundation on my forehead, because there is some product there already. So I'm going to put the rest of my face. And then I'm going to take my flat foundation brush that I mentioned earlier, and we're just gonna play the blending game. I find it that using a foundation brush for my foundation is better than using maybe some beauty blender, because beauty blenders, as we all know or should know, they suck up a lot of product, guys. So this, and they move your product around your face, like they don't just blend it in that place where it is. So I prefer using a foundation brush. It doesn't move the product around, and it doesn't eat as much product, because it does eat product obviously, but not as much product as what a beauty blender would do. Baby, you are my love completely. I love you with my life for all time. Okay, so once I think that my foundation brush has settled in most of it, I go back with my beauty blender and lightly I blend in some more. It's all over the face. Okay, now we move on to my favorite part, is contouring, guys. Like, I won't even lie. Let's highlight first.
Yeah. What if you've got...
Guys, we're gonna do the highlight first. Because I was so going to come. Like, I need excess fallouts from my eyeshadow.
Yes. You know what I wanted to say.
So I've got a highlight first. You highlight your face with a shade, two shades lighter than you are, and you'd conceal with the shade two times, not conceal, sorry, you'd contour with a concealer shade that's two times darker than you. So contouring is basically you just carving out your face, trying to make it look slimmer, you know. So if you, for example, have a much wider forehead, you'd contour a lot more than highlighting, because if you highlight your forehead and you have like a wide forehead, it's just going to make it look bigger. And then you carve out your cheekbones, but if you've already got that, you know, sharp ass cheekbone, then there's absolutely no need for you to contour even more, unless that's the look that you're going for. So you'd contour just on your cheekbones, on I don't know what they call this part of your forehead, it's called something, but I don't know what it's called. And then on your nose. So if you've got if you want to make your nose appear a lot more slimmer and smaller, you'd contour like here, and then underneath here. I like doing that, I don't know, it just makes a difference for me. Okay, so I prefer using foundation for my contouring. I don't know why, but I use this Revlon Colorstay Full Cover Foundation in the shade 420. That's what I used to contour, and I'm not really a big fan of highlighting. I don't highlight my face much, but when I do, I mix, and by mix, I probably just put a little bit of this, but this is the, oopsie, wrong one. This is the Revlon Candid Photo Ready Concealer in the shade 30, and I mix it with my fawn. So I'd use both of these to highlight my face sharp. So now that that's done, so I just put here, guys, we don't need to be highlighting like mad people anymore.
Did you not already do that?
No, before I was concealing my under eyes. So now I'm highlighting. Now, did you see where I put it, guys? I hope limpone, because I can't go blela tata. So I'm just going to put, like I said, just a little bit of the lighter one here and here. Here. It is. Ish. That's a little, guys. I don't like highlighting. Like, guys, I hate it. This is the last time. Grow on and grow. My what's are creasing?
Yeah, this thing.
Eyelids, because there's no product there. I still have to move this product up. I want to let a little pop. Tabadi adi pause. I know. I know it's yours. Okay, so I don't know if you guys can see, but you can clearly see like defining lines, and I don't like that. So I take my beauty blender and we blend that out. Oh yeah, also that nose highlight, just leave it there, because it looks much better when you blend it out with the contour. I'll show you. So I'm gonna use my foundation, my favorite parts. I don't know why I like highlights it so much. I think it's because it brings in some color onto your face. So I'm going to put it here like that. And then, but not all the way, just like that. And then we are together now. Nah. Then foundation brush and blend that in. Like to move that into my hairline. Obviously, if you're wearing a closure, you'd put that in your closure. Lace, what? Lidibisa. Tonateo. Anyone in this room can attest to the fact that this is flawless. Anyone. And I'm gonna take my beauty blender, my best friend, and blend that highlighter in with the contour. I'm sure you guys could see, hurray. Okaro lebet, akalebala. Akalebala. So this highlight and contour, just so that you know, we have one team. Then this over here. I'm gonna take this brush that I was using for my highlighter and we're just going to lightly pat, take it up to the eyebrow. Lightly pat. Lift your eyebrows so that there's no excess skin getting in the way of perfection. You're trying to bring it as close as you can to that highlight. Then this process is supposed to be super quick. It's just that I have someone distracting me because if you're not quick, ne? So I'm going to take my beauty blender and just blend that with the rest of my face. But if you're not quick, ne? This is going to start creasing and we have to set it. So you set all of that cream on your face. Can you imagine if you're going to have a full day and you're not going to set any of that? It's just going to be a nightmare. Because your face is just gonna look cakey and it's everything's just gonna crease, so you need to set it with powders, right? So to set your highlighter, you will use this. This is a loose powder or a translucent powder, but this is the Revlon New Photo Ready Candid setting powder. You'll set your highlighter with that. And then to set your contour. To set your contour, you'd use a contour like powder, like a brown, even if you have an eyeshadow that's like some light brown or depending on your skin tone. I personally prefer using this. So I actually use this. It's like a bronzer, but I mix it with this contour shade and I just highlight where I would have put the cream contour. And then once I have the photo ready loose powder underneath my eyes, I let it sit for about 5 to 10 minutes, not too long. I don't really like baking for long, but I do it because I notice that I crease here a lot during the summer. So during summer I definitely do bake, but winter time I really don't. I don't see a need for it because the oils in my skin aren't really seeping through my makeup. So I dust that off using my mattifying compact powder. And I just use the powder brush that I'll be using. I dust it off and then I pick up some more products and use it all over my face, so that it's almost like got like a clean finish and not like as if you can literally see where the contour powder is and where the highlighting setting powder is. Like, I just like everything to look like one thing. You understand what I'm saying? So I have it in this lid. By the way, it's damp, it's not dry. Thumbnail. By the way, I'm going to be going, like I told you, and then dust it off with the compact powder. Trust me, guys. I never used to do this, but now that I do it, like, I see a difference. Okay, and then I'm gonna let, like I said, this sit for a bit while I powder the contour. I'm gonna use my contour powder and mix them. You also want to make sure that that's well blended, because what's the point of working so hard to blend your face, your cream powders, and then you don't do the same with your contour bronzer. Okay, so this is where I do my eyeshadow. While this is here, like my sister said earlier, just to pick up the excess products from the eyeshadow. Okay guys, so I'm back with my eyeshadow done. I had some fallout, so I'm just gonna dust that off. Don't forget to press your brush in there while you're brushing it off. And there you have it, guys. Like, that's basically all I do. And then I'm gonna put on some blush, and because obviously I've already completed the cream part, I can't put a cream blush. I would have put that together with my contour. I'm gonna use my Beauty Hyper blush powder, and I'm gonna apply some blush just here. It's right above the cheekbone. And just spend some time blending that in. And then I'm gonna complete my face, and I'll see you guys just now. Okay guys, you've reached the end of my two-part series. If you did make it here, thank you so much for watching my videos, and I really do hope that you found it informative and that you could take some little tips and tricks that I used and apply them on your own makeup routine. But anyways guys, I'll see you in my next video. I love you. Bye.